don't miss any content. Don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell.
Liverpool thumped Crystal Palace 7-0, cementing their top spot, opening a 4-point gap at the top from Leicester City. They followed this after they had beaten Tottenham Hotspur 2-1 in midweek to end the top spot. Manchester United thrashed Leeds United 6-2 in what was a renewed rivalry which had not been played in the Premier League for a decade and a half. United winning 6-2 at Old Trafford. A rare home victory for the Red Devils this season. Spurs lost again, second consecutive loss in the Premier League following that loss to Liverpool that took top spot from them. They were beaten by Leicester City 2-0. Arsenal's woes continue. They slumped to another defeat to Everton. Thomas Partey is still out injured. Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang was out of this clash. In Spain, Atletico Madrid atop with a win over Elche. Real Madrid beat Eibar to go second in the La Liga table. Barcelona drew versus Valencia with Lionel Messi equaling Pelé's record for most goals for a single club, 643. Barca in fifth position. In Italy, Ronaldo's brace helped Juventus secure a 4-0 win over Parma, helping them maintain their unbeaten start to the season. Milan, 4 points at the top after their win, remain up there. Juventus up in third. In Germany, Dortmund lost again and Bayern were victorious. Welcome back to the channel. As usual, I am your host, Selassie Ifeawa. So today is time for performances of Ghanaian players abroad, and it was a great weekend, but not that much for Ghanaian players to cheer about. Daniel Amate thankfully returned to action for Leicester City in their 2-0 victory against Tottenham Hotspur. Also, we saw Caleb Okuman finding the back of the net for his Turkish side Trabzonspor in their victory over the weekend. As we know, the Ghana Premier League table looks like this, and Bechem United are on beating side in the Ghana Premier League, holding that top spot after beating Karela United, along with Ashanti Gold, have not lost a game in the Ghana Premier League. This is how it looks like. Karela United, despite that loss, are second with 11 points. Great Olympics following their two victories in the week against Kotoko and also Wafa are third on the table. Wafa are fourth, Ashanti Gold fifth, Elmina Sharks, Asante Kotoko, and Heart of Oak in that order. Subscribe if you haven't. Click on the notification bell to get more updates. We'll start off from England whilst we are looking at the performance of Ghanaian players abroad. And on Saturday lunchtime, Crystal Palace took on Liverpool. Jordan Ayew and Jeffrey Schlupp were in full throttle for Crystal Palace as they slumped to a 7-0 defeat at the hands of a ruthless Liverpool side whose chances were just hitting the back of the net. Almost every shot Liverpool had hit the back of the net. Mo Salah came off the bench, scored twice. Sadio Mane found the back of the net. Minamino found the back of the net. Jordan Henderson found the back of the net. The usually misfiring Bobby Firmino found the back of the net. It was a great day for the Reds, not so much for Crystal Palace, who had two Ghanaians in Jeffrey Schlupp and Jordan Ayew in there for the full 90 minutes of this humiliation. Southampton took on Manchester City, and Mohamed Salisu, for the third consecutive game, sat it out on the bench. He was an unused substitute. His side succumbed to a 1-0 victory to Manchester City. Newcastle took on Fulham. It was a 1-1 draw in the end. Dennis Odoi played for Fulham as an unused substitute. Christian Atsu's situation with his club still remains the same. Not in the squad for the season. Brentford took on Reading, and Tarik Fosu, who played at right back in this side, helped his team to a 3-1 victory over Reading, where Andiado was not in the squad. Swansea took on Barnsley, and Andre Ayew played the full 90 minutes of this encounter as his Swansea side won 2-0 versus Barnsley. Wycombe Wanderers took on QPR. Albert Adoma was an unused substitute for QPR. They drew 1-1 with Wycombe Wanderers. Spurs took on Leicester City, and it was a return to action for Daniel Amate, coming on as a substitute in the 60th minute as his side beat Tottenham Hotspur 2-0. Everton beat Arsenal 2-1. Thomas Partey out injured, not in the squad entirely. In Spain, Celta Vigo, they took on Deportivo Alaves. It was a 2-0 victory for Deportivo Alaves. Jose Vedo came on in injury time for this game. Very little time for him to play in this encounter. Mallorca took on Fuenlabrada, and it was Idrissou Baba who came on in the 67th minute. His side lost 3-2. And now in Italy, Inter Milan took on Spezia, and it was Emmanuel Chessy. He played 80 minutes for Spezia. They lost 2-1 to Inter Milan. Fiorentina and Hellas Verona squared off, and it was a 1-1 draw. Alfred Duncan, out with an injury, was not in the squad. Emmanuel Ajimambedu, not in the squad as well. Pescara took on AC Monza. Prince Boateng played the full throttle. His side lost 3-2 to Pescara. Now in Germany, Borussia Mönchengladbach, they took on Hoffenheim. It was a 2-1 victory for Hoffenheim. Kasim Adams, an unused substitute for Hoffenheim. Paderborn SC took on VfL Osnabrück. It was a 1-0 victory for Paderborn SC. Christopher Ntriaje not in the squad for this one. Eintracht Braunschweig took on Grethaforth. A 3-0 victory for Grethaforth, and unused substitute Jamie Lewelik did not take part in this game. St. Pauli took on Fortuna Düsseldorf. Kevin Danso played 90 minutes of the encounter. Kelvin Ofori was an unused substitute for Fortuna Düsseldorf. Jan Regensburg took on Hannover 96. Patrick Chumesi was not in the squad for Hannover 96. In France, Valenciennes took on Amiens, and Nicolas Opoku got a red card, second bookable offense for him. In the 55th minute, he was sent off for his second yellow card. Emmanuel Lomote played 90 minutes in defense for Amiens. And Metz took on RC Lens, and Boy played a full 90 minutes. 2-0 victory for Metz. Strasbourg took on Bordeaux. Alexandre Djikou played 90 minutes. Majid Waris came on in the 79th minute. Bordeaux beat Strasbourg 2-0. In Belgium, Zulte Waregem, they took on St. Trudy's VV. Samuel Asamoah was not in the squad for St. Trudy's VV. Bulgaria and Ludogorets Razgrad took on Botev Plovdiv. It was a 2-1 victory for Ludogorets. Tekbete coming on in the 72nd minute of the encounter. In India, Northeast United took on Jamshedpur. Kwesi Appiah played 54 minutes. His side lost 1-0 on this occasion. In Serbia, in the Serbian Cup, Rad Boygard took on Red Star Belgrade. Richmond Boacheadom, he played 90 minutes as his side won 2-1 on this occasion. In Switzerland, Basel took on St. Gallen. It was a 0-0 draw. Lawrence Atizigi keeping a clean sheet here, both teams sharing the spoils. He played the full 90 minutes. In Turkey, Trabzonspor, they took on Kayserispor. And Caleb Ekuban was on target in the 53rd minute from the spot. He played 82 minutes as his side beat Kayserispor 2-1. Yeni Malatyaspor beat Kasımpaşa 2-0. Efriye Akwa played 90 minutes of the encounter. Beşiktaş took on Büyükşehir Belediye. 4-0 victory for Beşiktaş. Bernard Mensah played 73 minutes of the encounter. Gençler Birliği took on Ankara Gücü, and it was a 1-1 draw. Josef Pinto came on in the 46th minute. In Austria, Red Bull Salzburg, they took on Wolfsberger AC. Majid Ashimeru was an unused substitute as his side succumbed to a 3-2 loss on this occasion. So that was the performances of Ghanaian players abroad over the weekend. The Ghana Premier League table, how it looks like. Great games to look at over the weekend. Interesting things that happen. Remember, the same weekend, Manchester United and Liverpool succumbed to those huge losses to Aston Villa and to Tottenham Hotspur. This same weekend, they have redeemed themselves by the same goals they suffered. United scoring 6 versus Leeds, Liverpool scoring 7 versus Crystal Palace after losing 7 against Aston Villa, and also United after losing 6 at home against Tottenham Hotspur. Quite a weird weekend, quite an interesting one, but great to see Daniel Amati back in action. He has come back even before the January deadline that he was given, so the festive period, sure to see him in action and more. It's going to be an interesting festive period. Hope you are getting ready for the festive period of TIFO, amazing football. There'll be midweek fixtures in the EFL Cup, in the Italian Serie A, there'll be games, and across Germany, across Europe, across the world. Kumasi Asantekotoko will be preparing to square off with Al Hilal here in Ghana in the CAF Champions League second preliminary stages. It's sure to be interesting. More football to look at. But let me know your standout game of the weekend. This weekend, it was a great weekend. Beautiful football, swashbuckling game by Leeds and Manchester United, ruthlessness by Liverpool. Who was your standout Ghanaian performer? Ekuban, great to see him on the score sheet once again. Let me know your thoughts in the comments box. I'll see you guys in the next one. Enjoy your day.